The British Overseas Territories boasts a rich heritage even in the modern era. The former colonies in South Africa gained freedom and formed alliances. And to ensure their hard-fought freedom never slips away, their armies require tools that will help protect it. This is the Ruikat, an extremely mobile reconnaissance vehicle that the SANDF commissioned in 1976 from the Britain-based Rumish as a replacement for the obsolete French armored cars. And the RSA had been lucky enough to get their hands on a true predator by the end of the 80s. The Ruikat, with its 76mm armament, made for an excellent scout as well as a hunter. In addition to that, one of its modifications was even fitted with a powerful 105mm cannon. In War Thunder, both variants of this vehicle can be found in the British tech tree. Here we will tell you about the premium exclusive unit equipped with a 105mm cannon. Armament. The most obvious and important distinction of the premium build, the 105mm GT7 cannon can fire not only armor-piercing fin-stablish and high-explosive shells, but hit rounds too. The 76mm build of the Caracal is deprived of such awesome features. The cannon's multipurposeness in combat has gone up too. The gunner's got a quality thermal imaging unit at his disposal on the 105mm build. Furthermore, your go-to victory snatching tool has been equipped with a stabilizer, meaning that the firing on the move won't be a problem for this vehicle. Layout. Dense in the turret and very sparse in the hull. The 32-round complement is evenly disturbed alongside the central part of the fighting compartment. 16 first-order rounds are packed together next to the loader as well as behind him. Survivability. Low. The Caracal's hull can be destroyed with ease, and its armor is only good enough to shield it from machine gun fire. The vehicle will rarely survive a direct hit, so it's important you pay close attention to its mobility characteristics, detailed in the next section. Mobility. Fantastic. The Ruikat is one of the fastest-wheeled vehicles in War Thunder, able to reach a speed of 120 km per hour. However, you should also account for the wheelbase of this Predator, as it's very fickle on dirt terrain. Don't forget that the roads in the maps aren't just there for beauty purposes. They can easily double your speed when you're trying to reach a vantage or capture point. The Caracal's max reverse speed of 47 km per hour allows it to really shine in city engagements, when you can just roll back in narrow streets if you wish to escape from an enemy tank. Oh, and here is another useful perk for you. The complex transmission can help you change the direction in which you are moving very abruptly. Be sure to make good use of that on open terrain. Use in battle. This vehicle is designed for fast-paced yet careful gameplay. Use all methods at hand to remain undetected and take unconventional routes. Choose spots from which it's not easy to deliver fire, and do your thing with enabled thermal imaging. You'll be able to spot the bright heat signatures of the opponents through the thicket without any problem. And most importantly, remember, you bought first and foremost a fantastic cannon. Read more about the Ruikat 105 on the War Thunder Wiki.